Our Sunday night broadcast on 2K Sports. For a starter, focus and determination, absolutely essential. This man's got both. Adam Wainwright, one of the best. Our site for this ballgame tonight is Busch Stadium, the home of the Cardinals. And what is this Philadelphia lineup going to see from him today, Steve?
I've got a good right-hander on the mound and a good lineup that he's facing right here. And it's going to come down to execution on either side to see who prevails.
Here's the lineup for the Phillies. Any of these bats stand out, John?
Well, Andrew McCutchen's a guy that when he first came up, we knew about the blinding speed. We knew he had the ability to put the ball in play. We thought he might be just be a singles hitter, but all of a sudden, this power starting to evolve. That's why he's moved around in the lineup. Looks like now he's entrenched in that third spot. Great place for him because he can do so many things for you.
And it's Andrew McCutchen leading off our ballgame.
For the Philadelphia Phillies, left fielder number 22, Andrew McCutchen.
The pitch from Wainwright. First pitch fastball. Misses badly that time. 1-0. In there at the letters, evening the count. 1-1.
He throws that cut fastball up and into the hitter. Kind of surprised him. He couldn't offer at it.
One on the way. Good looking fastball. Called the ball though. 2-1. He watches the fastball go by. Now it's 2-2.
Some guys really like the low fastball. In this situation though, he ends up taking the pitch.
Sinker misses, and it's full, 3-2.
And when he can keep that thing down and away, it's nearly impossible to hit.
There's a swing and a ground ball. Wong. One away now. We'll take a quick look at the Cardinals and how they're lined up on the field. And scouting those fielders, John.
Yeah, the weapon. I mean, Yadier Molina, there's no better catcher in the game defensively than Yadier Molina. Not only does he keep runners close at first base because he can throw behind the hitter and pick them off at first base, he blocks balls better than anyone. To me, if you're going to build a catcher and a model catcher, Yadier Molina is that guy.
Here's the delivery. Line drive fouled off towards first. Here's the pitch. Takes that curve. 0-1 pitch for a strike, 0-2.
The hitter needs a two-strike approach. Shorten up the swing. Think about going the other way.
Strike three called. Home plate umpire racks him up 2-0.
A textbook way of pitching. Three pitches, three strikes.
Outstanding command during that at bat. We've got Harper in the box. That one's high. Wainwright doesn't fool him.
Well, that's just some good old country hardball right there. Four-seam fastball up in the zone.
The 1-0 pitch. Harper hits this one. Carpenter throws to first, side is retired. And a good half inning there, gone in short order in this one. Bottom half coming right up. St. Louis Cardinals. It will be Jake Arrieta on the mound. He'll get the start for Philadelphia. And as he gets into this St. Louis lineup, Steve, what's the primary emphasis?
Well, Jake Arrieta's put away pitches, that big sweeping slider, which means that he has to work ahead of the count early with his fastball, set up the slider, and then expand the zone.
This is popped down the right field line. Should be room. One away. This is how the Cardinals are lining up.
They take a look at this lineup, and these are guys that are in scoring position when they step the home plate because they can take the ball out of the ballpark and hit a bunch of home runs.
And here's the defensive alignment for the Phillies. And, John, any scouting picks?
Well, we all know that the center field position is manned by great athletes, and one of the best one out there is Andrew McCutchen. This guy can go get him in any direction, and his arm, although some people think that it's not as strong as it should be, very accurate, and he throws a lot of people out.
And he swings and hits this one foul. Arrieta will probably try and get him to chase one to the 0-2.
Well, you can tell he was looking for something hard, and he got that sinker down and in. He swung through it.
He delivers. Curveball. Thought he had him, but it's 1-2.
The best curveballs are the ones that start in the strike zone, then fall out of the strike zone. He couldn't get him to fish for that one, though.
Swing and lined up the middle. Base hit. Gets it down. That's our first hit of the game.
He takes this 1-2 hit down in the zone. He's able to go down and get it. Get a good part of the bat on the ball and pick up the base hit.
That's a tough pitch to hit when you're behind in the count. You just want contact, and he got it. And in the batter's box, it's Ozuna.
Well, when you win 102 games in a season like they did in 2011, the Phillies beat up on everybody, including the National League Central, in which they went 27-16.
Here's the pitch. Fastball in there for a called strike. Regarding that Phillies record, at one point in the second half, they had knocked off 12 consecutive wins, Steve, against the division in the Central.
Oh, that's right. Late July, early August, the race was over in the National League East as the Phillies got hot and distanced themselves from everybody.
Line drive. That's foul towards first. A swing and a foul off to the right side.
Well, 1-2 count that pitch on the outside part of the plate. Borderline pitch. You still don't know if it's going to be a ball or a strike. The last thing you want to do is take that pitch for a called strike three.
And they get two. Great double play. No runs, one hit, and no one left on base. We're scoreless in St. Louis. Part of the order due to bat next. At the plate, their rookie first baseman. He'll start us out here in the second. For 17. Swings and misses. The sinker, 0-1.
Well, he was way behind on that one. Must have been looking for something else.
Hit up the middle. He stops at first. It'll be a single.
Well, a great job right there by the first hitter in this inning to get on base. And, you know, a lot of big innings are started with that first guy getting on. And you have one or two big innings in a game, and that can be the difference in the outcome.
The pitch from Wainwright. Breaking ball, swung on and missed. 0-1.
Gary, he gets a little over-anxious at the plate when the count goes to 0-1, so look for them maybe to expand the strike zone and get him to chase something.
To left center. That's one away.
Shifted the outfielders to the left. He hit it to left.
Number 30.
Going to be Herrera now.
Well, what a surprise a year ago. So many people thought that the Cardinals would lose to the Phillies, but in the end, what an upset. The Cardinals win and advance all the way to the World Series.
One out, runner on at first. And a swinging strike on the first pitch by Wainwright, 0-1. And certainly that series, Cardinals-Phillies, the great game, the 1-0 pitcher's duel, Holiday and Chris Carpenter, Game 5. That's great baseball.
Unbelievable matchup and great pitching. The Cardinals scored on back-to-back hits to lead off the top of the first inning. And that's all Chris Carpenter needed, one of the biggest clutch performances in the history of baseball.
Curveball just off the black, and it's 2-1.
Well, unfortunately for Adam Wainwright in 2011, the injury bug bit him early. It bit him prior to the season, unable to pitch, and now they're hoping he's going to come back and become what he used to be.
Lined, foul, towards third. Boy, what an addition to a world championship it would be to come back the next year and have Adam Wainwright available to pitch. That's going to be a big plus.
When you think about it, I mean, they don't have to even make a trade or free agent signing. They've got a top-flight pitcher coming back in. It may take some time, but he'll return to form.
The 3-2 pitch. Sinker swung on, missed. That's out number two.
He threw the sinker ball out of the zone. He got the hitter to chase it for a strikeout. You need better plate discipline than that.
It's going to be Hernandez. There he goes towards second.
Ball.
And his throw, he is out. Great throw. So no runs on one hit and nobody left on. Still unable to score. Philadelphia still zero. Splendid evening here at Busch Stadium. Night overhead sky of St. Louis. Lights on. Goldschmidt at the plate. He's got three hits, six at-bats against the Phillies. 0-1 the count. Getting going here in the bottom of the second.
Well, that's a pretty good pitch right there. He got that slider in the strike zone. He got the hitter out in front to swing early.
Strike two, and Paul Goldschmidt now will have to be careful as the strikeout's close. Strike three as Paul Goldschmidt goes down without a swing on that pitch.
Number four.
K-Cam's going to show us the four-seam fastball here.
Nice-looking strikeout pitch high up in the zone, just frozen.
It might have been up in the zone, Gary, but when you have two strikes on, you better take your chances and swing the bat.
And it's Yadier Molina now with one away.
Well, not many National League teams fared very well against the NL East, but the Cardinals did, going 22-13.
Towards the middle. And he pulls into first base with that base hit. There's one down here. That Cardinals record against the National League East also included Victor Steve against the Phillies.
How about winning 6 of 9 from them? And that was, I think, an indicator that this Cardinals team could stand toe-to-toe with the best in baseball.
Wong gets a shot here. That's on the outside corner for a strike.
When he's behind in the count, he's just not a good fastball hitter, so I expect him to attack him with the fastball.
He deals. Swings and grounds this one to the right side. Foul. Here's the pitch. Hit hard on the ground towards third. And that gets through for a base hit. A prime chance for production for the Cardinals. Boy, I don't know on that count, Steve. Number one, the fact that he swung's kind of a surprise. I don't know how he hit that. Where it was.
You're right. On an 0-2 count, you have to protect the plate. Sometimes it's a defensive swing, but sometimes it works out.
One out with runners at first and second. Sliders in there for a called strike. Here's a swing and a fly ball to right center. And that'll put him on another hit. Molina's trying to the plate. And Molina comes on.
Now he's surrendered to three straight hits. He's got to bounce back and get this guy. He's out.
Number eight spot in the lineup. And we believe this lineup looks as though they're ready to do some more damage. Still a ways to go, but pitching's going to catch up here. Here's the pitch.
0-1.
Had a big rip at that one and falls behind 0-1. Well, what types of pitches have been put in play here today? Here's a quick breakdown of exactly that.
The pitch I've been watching is that curve. It's been hit twice already.
No, John, I think he needs to be more careful throwing that pitch. I mean, look at the four hits total he's given up on it. We're only in the second inning. He needs to conserve energy and be more efficient overall and find something to get hitters out.
Sinker's taken, strike three called, out number two. Well, you get a runner in scoring position early in the ball game. That's a chance they don't take advantage of.
Yeah, and that's one of those at-bats right there that could come back later in the game to hurt you. Got him out quickly, though.
It's Wainwright at the plate. Boy, pitcher needs to get an out here. If you don't, you're going to have the potential for a very big inning offensively. Here's your big-time opportunity to put something up on the board. And it's fouled off. Here's the delivery. Arrieta will probably try and get him to chase one to the 0-2.
A good sinking movement on that pitch right on the black away from the hitter. Tough pitch to hit.
On the ground to second. Played by Hernandez. Throws on to first in time to retire the side. Getting things going early, they get a run in the second. The Redbirds lead it 1-0. It's going to be Hernandez.
Number 16, Cesar Hernandez.
Here's a swing, a fly ball deep down the line and right. And it's caught by Fowler.
Michael Franco.
Franco in the box now. The pitch from Wainwright. This one has popped up to the left side out of play. The pitch. Takes a swing at that 0-1 pitch, but the curve is in there for strike two. Now Molina positions himself. Swung on, missed, curveball struck him out too down. Boy, nice looking set of pitches that time. He didn't dabble around with the strike zone.
Well, nothing wasted, just three pitches over the plate, sits him down.
And it's Arrieta at the plate. And Wainwright misses outside, taken for a ball. The 1-0 now. Sinker just off the black, falls behind 2-0. Swung on, that is hit. So Andrew McCutchen will come up.
Well, you know what? I've seen better swings in a park, but the pitcher able to pick up a base hit right there. And, hey, nothing like helping yourself.
Grounded out last time. Here's the first pitch.
Strike one!
And that finds the outside corner for strike one. And here's a quick summary of how this guy's mixing up his pitches. How's he doing?
Well, when you're playing behind a guy, you love to see him mix up his pitches, change speeds. But when you're in the batter's box, it can create a lot of havoc for the hitter. He's done a great job of that today.
Yeah, for the most part, he's been keeping the hitters guessing, not knowing or anticipating what pitch they're going to get. He's able to change it up no matter what the count.
One-one pitch is a cut fastball taken for a strike, one and two.
A cut fastball just ran inside on the hitter's hands. He had no chance to even get out and swing at it. Tough pitch.
The 1-2 on its way.
You're out.
And Andrew McCutchen misses. That's going to be strike three. Good work there, Adam Wainwright. He continues to dominate through three innings of work. Up next, Cardinals.
At the plate.
Hitting it off, Dexter Fowler. Cardinals. Over his lifetime, 293
Dexter
off the Phillies.
Fowler.
Here we go. Here's the first pitch. First pitch is a sinker for a called strike. Now, let's take a moment here to see the breakdown of the pitches that have yielded hits.
Looking at this guy's curve, that pitch has been hit two times.
You know, with that pitch, it's the only time they've been able to get wood on the ball. Still looking great overall right now in the third, as he's been on the mark with what he's throwing up there, but that's the pitch they've gotten to him.
Here's the delivery. A shot up the middle, and that's through a base hit.
Well, this guy's got a lot of speed over there at first base, and it's not going to be surprised to see him off and running to try to steal his base.
It's going to be Carpenter now. Looked good in his first at bat, came away with a single off Arrieta.
The last time these two matched up, he saw that slider, and he certainly wasn't fooled as he laced the base hit.
Yeah, and that single he had last time didn't drive anyone in. However, he showed he can hit him and is looking to get something in the gap to bring home the guy on first.
And the pitch out, nothing doing that time. Here's the 1-0. Low for a ball, 2-0. And, you know, any great pitching coach will emphasize the importance of mixing up your pitch types. Let's see how this guy's been doing in that regard.
Well, so far in this one, he's gone to that curve more so than he usually does with that pitch.
You know, it's interesting. I don't know why. You know, the scouting report is that he goes to that four-seam fastball for his outs. For whatever reason, he's not going there. But I think he needs to get back into that routine of what makes him successful.
The pitch. Sinker is in there. Call the ball. Beg your pardon. 3-1.
Well, even though you're 3-1 in the count, you still have to be patient at the plate. Make him throw a quality pitch. If he does, be ready for it. And if you're the pitcher, you better not throw anything down the middle and hope he's taking it, because he can take you out of the yard.
One, and that's two. A double play. Nice play, especially on the relay to first. 4-6-3.
That's textbook right there. Tailor-made double play. Hit it where they are and turn it.
And in the batter's box, it's Ozuna. He hit into a double play his last time. First pitch on the way. Now swing and a shot toward second. He'll throw on to first, and that'll do it for this half inning. No runs, one hit, and no one left on base. Cardinals 1, Philadelphia nothing. And if you're just joining in, Gary Thorne with Steve Phillips and John Kruk bringing you Major League Baseball here on 2K Sports. Swing, hot shot. Oh, look out. Wainwright, and his throw is in time for out number one. But a quick recovery that time gets the out. We've got Harper in the box.
Wainwright has great stuff, and he has the ability to be a great pitcher. Well, today, he has been great.
Let's take a look at what he's doing on these first pitch to hitters.
The first pitch of an at-bat may be the most critical pitch of the at-bat, especially when you get strike one. He's gotten six hitters out today when he's gone 0-1 in the count.
Fouled off. Here's the pitch. And it's taken outside by Harper for a ball.
Again, we're into the fourth inning right now, and as you start to flip the lineup over again, you know, they've only gotten two hits, so they're going to have to really evaluate what they should be looking for at the plate, and maybe they need to be a little bit more patient and make them work.
Good spot that time. Hit that outside corner. 1-2.
He's up ahead 1-2 right here. Don't be surprised if he comes with the curveball to try to get the strikeout.
And Wainwright's pitch too low, taken for a ball.
Well, Gary, his two-strike approach, he does not handle the fastball very well, so let's see if they attack him with some heat.
Line drive fouled off towards first. Curveball, it's in there. Struck him out, two down now.
Now this curveball just drops right off the table. The hitter thought he had a beat on it, then he gave up as it breaks into the strike zone.
Cleanup man in the box again. Well, it's truly been a tremendous day on the mound for this man. Here's a breakdown of how he's been mixing up his locations, using that to his advantage.
But we've been watching him go high, go low. He's forcing this lineup to think a lot, and when hitters think, they're done.
And it makes it hard to swing confidently when they don't have their bearings in the box. They don't know location or speed, and right now they're just swinging over the top of everything.
A line drive towards short. Now with two down, they've got a man on board.
Well, two quick outs in the inning, you think maybe this is one of those quick innings and the other team gets in and they get some momentum, but it keeps the inning alive with that base hit.
Up again now, the number five spot. He's in his fourth year now. First pitch on the way. It's fouled away. On the way. Lays off the curveball. Good pitch, though. 1-1. He delivers. And he looks at a sinker in there. And it's 1-2 now. Fastball, that's well off the plate, 2-2. He swings, it's a ball to right field. And he's there to retire the side. No runs at a base hit, they leave one man on at first. St. Louis, they're protecting their lead. Keeping up with the hit trends in this one, let's take a look at the pitches that he's thrown on the mound. Swinging a drive, deep left center. And McCutcheon, that's a good play.
They had the outfield swung around to right that time, so they had a long way to go to run that ball down.
And it's Yadier Molina now with one away. So far, a 1-for-1 in the game off Arrieta.
You know, if I'm in the box, I'm looking for a fastball. I'm going to try to be aggressive when I get it. But I have to understand that because I got the hit, he may not throw it for a strike and try to get me to chase. So I need to be patient.
There's a ground ball. Number two. Two down here in the inning.
For the St. Louis Cardinals, second baseman. Number 16.
Wong up at the plate. He had a single in his last time up. Pitch on the way. Sinker just missed. 1-0.
Well, he missed with the first pitch, so I'll bet he's going to come back with the fastball right here, as he's done in the past.
The 1-0 pitch. A swing and a fly ball to left center field. And it's going to be McCutchen. That's caught. Side is retired. Well, 1-2-3 inning for Jake Arrieta. He needs that offense now. He's doing his part. Only a run allowed through four. We played four full at Busch. New up 6-7-8 in the lineup. Be Herrera now. First time up, he didn't have much luck. Struck out swinging against Wainwright.
You got to believe that he's going to see the sinker again right here. Walking back to the dugout, very frustrated that he swung over the top of it the last time.
First pitch is a change up low, 1-0.
Well, offensively, they just have not been able to get anything going. Only one runner left on base, so they just need more opportunities and see if they can't capitalize on it.
1-0 on the way. Fouled away.
Foul ball!
Here's the 1-1 pitch. Change up just off the black, and it's 2-1.
Well, he tried to change up right there, but it just stayed down and off the plate.
2-1 pitch. Cut fastball that time. Didn't bite, though, and it's now 3-1.
Well, anytime you have a count 3-1 in your favor as the hitter, you're looking for a pitch in a little box in the location you want to. If he throws it in there, you better be ready and get a good hack at it.
The right center. And Herrera is one down. It's going to be Hernandez. Last time on Hernandez. Here's the first pitch.
Strike one!
And it's 0-1. Wainwright with him looking there. Now, when you put a game together like we've seen here from this pitcher, it only comes with throwing a lot of quality strikes. Here's how he's getting it done.
When you're pitching as well as he has, you got the confidence factor.
He sends this one in the air towards center. Two men have been put away.
That's about as easy as a guess. He should have caught that one in the back pocket.
Franco is the batter. Struck out swinging last time. The pitch. And it goes foul. Back up the middle, Wong. Throws on to first, side is retired. Not a lot of action in this half inning, nothing on. The shutout continuing here at Busch Stadium. Bottom three, due up next.
Up to the plate.
And if you've just joined our broadcast, great to have you on board. 2K Sports Major League Baseball, I'm Gary Thorne with Steve Phillips and John Crump. Boy, he scorched that one. That was right over the mound. In time for the other.
Now, credit the second baseman with a well-executed play right there. Comes up with the ball and quickly gets it from his glove to his throwing hand and throws him out at first.
In the box again there, left fielder. And here's a quick chance to look at how this guy has been mixing up his locations to this lineup.
He's done a great job when you look at this pitch location. A lot of pitches down and away from the hitters.
You know, listen, I love guys who be able to move the ball around and keep it off the middle of the plate, but you can't throw just to one spot and favor one spot. He's going to have to mix it up a little bit.
Now the first pitch. Oh! Fastball just misses, 1-0.
Well, that right there is a really good pitch, just missing the outside corner. Give the batter a lot of credit, though. That is one of the toughest pitches to lay off of, that hard fastball away.
Hit in the air to center field. He catches that, and that's out number two.
Number 50.
It's Wainwright at the plate. Grounded out his last time up.
Thank you.
and starts him out here. Sinker swung on, missed 0-1. What's he doing to start these hitters out? Let's take a look at how he's beginning.
You want your pitchers to be aggressive and go at the hitters and work ahead in the count. And first pitch strike's the way to do it. Well, in this game, he's retired 8 hitters after he's gone to an 0-1 count.
And another foul ball.
Well, you can tell right there that the batter is in protection mode. Anything close, he's just trying to put it in play. The fact that he fouled it off will keep this at-bat going.
Here's the pitch. Curveball, that tied him up and not. Swung on and missed. Side retired. And they're unable to make any noise here in this half inning. And it'll be the Phillies. Now the first pitch. It's 0-1 as he swings and misses at that fastball.
Gary, he's not felt any pressure out there on the mound. The defense has not felt that much pressure either. With only one runner left on base, and you know we're moving through the middle part of this ball game, so you know they're doing a nice job shutting down this offense.
Great confidence right there in the stuff. Could have wasted a pitch right there, but he figured, why worry?
That's a great job of finishing off the batter in a hurry. Never got a chance to see much. Here's Andrew McCutchen at the plate.
A mix of good and bad for Andrew McCutchen in 2011. He took a step forward as a player who could drive in runs, but also saw a strikeout rate increase and hit for a career low 259.
Here we go. Here's the first pitch. Cut fastball. Swung on and missed. 0-1. For McCutchen, a question of does it matter where he hits. The number three spot, he did pretty well, but not, John, at the same rate as when he was batting leadoff.
And a lot of times when you move a young player from leadoff to the third spot, the mindset changes. He thinks, now I have to be a power hitter.
That swung on, line towards the gap in left center. And it's through. The base hit for McCutchen. He's going to try to stretch it.
Only one out here in the inning, so a good opportunity here if they can string a couple hits together to make this a very productive inning.
There's shortstop in the box. He bounced out his last time. Here's the first pitch. He sends this one in the air towards center. Two away.
Now batting for the Philadelphia Phillies, right fielder, number 3, Bryce Harper.
And Bryce Harper looks ready in that batter's box. He wants to deliver in the clutch.
Two outs and a runner on second. And the first pitch. Oh! And that ball there as Wainwright misses. Pitch, a sinker in there, 1-1.
Well, that's textbook use of the sinker. Down and away, pounding the strike zone. Good pitch.
Dan Molina's calling for the pitch. Watches that fastball go by, and now he's at 1-2.
Well, they're a strike away right now from getting out of this jam and holding on to the lead.
And Wainwright with a 1-2 delivery. Ends up foul. Here's the pitch. And that's another foul ball.
Well, anytime you're behind in the count, and in this case the 1-2 count, you have to maintain that focus. You have to really be dialed into what the pitcher's throwing. You have to get in that defensive mode, though, and make sure you can foul it off, and that's what he did there to keep himself going.
You're Rounds him up. Steve, we got 3 innings left to go in this ball game. He's got the shutout going. We'll see whether or not he's got enough to go through.
Well, it's a fantastic effort so far. Now it comes down to heart. Does he have the heart to finish it off?
Fowler at the plate. He'll lead off the bottom half of the sixth.
Fowler.
First pitch on the way. Third ball just misses. I don't know. His last at bat, he picked up a single off Arrieta.
I saw the breaking ball last time up and didn't seem to hesitate putting a good swing on it and getting a hit. He's got to consider maybe going a different approach right here and saving the breaking ball for later in the game.
Here's the 1-1. That one's low. Fowler not going.
Flat fastball right there. Just missed. Just below the knees. Tell you what, borderline pitch. I think they wanted that one bad.
Dexter Fowler now has the count in his favor as he goes to 3-1.
Well, you've got to be careful right here. Look, you're down in the count 3-1. You just can't throw something in there and hope he gets himself out. This guy's too dangerous for that.
3-1 is a sinker that's by him. 3-2.
Just out in front of that sinker, and he comes up empty.
3-2 on the way. Ground ball to short. Number two. One away.
He's got everything working for him right now. Every pitch, he's throwing for a strike. And that's 9 in a row that he's set down.
It's going to be Carpenter now. 1-for-2 in the ballgame. Here it comes. Hit in the air to left center. And it's going to be McCutchen. As he gets to it for the out.
Well, this ball was headed to the gap, but the left fielder got a good jump on it, able to run it down and make the play.
And in the batter's box, it's Ozuna. Ground out victim last time through. The first pitch. Hit hard to second. Hernandez in position. And he throws on to first. That'll retire the side. And nothing across here in this half of the inning. Cardinals 1. Philadelphia nothing.
Now up to the plate.
And the first baseman in. He's looked sharp tonight. Couple of hits, 2 at-bats. Off Wainwright.
You know, he might want to go to the four-seam fastball again. But after the hit he gave up the last time, you may want to wait till the right time of the count to go there.
Into the alleyway. He'll likely get extra bases on this.
Well, you talk about a guy who's swinging a pretty hot bat right now. His third hit of this ball game, and it comes with nobody out in the inning.
Catcher up to the plate. He flew out his last time up. And here's the first one. Ball. Cutter just misses. 1-0.
Well, the batters can expect to see his bread and butter, that cutter today, Gary. A lot of guys are going to commit early. They've got to try to get a read and keep that pitch over the plate.
There's a swing. Line drive, center field. And he's on. That's the go-ahead run. And it's tied up. The tying run crosses the plate.
Just the same. See the shutout broken up right there, Gary. But still, just a tremendous performance today.
A productive hit. Checking the WPA graph, let's measure what the RBI means.
Well, what a great call by the catcher to throw that pitch up and away, and the pitcher executed the pitch. Problem was, it was a better piece of hitting. He showed great discipline just to put that ball in play.
The first pitch, bouncing off with one at the knees for a strike. Here we go with a little breakdown on the types of pitches that he's throwing on the mound that are turning into hits.
Well, this guy's sinker has been hit 2 times over the court.
That swung on and flied to right. That's one away. It's going to be Hernandez. 0-for-2 this time. Runner at first with one down. First pitch on the way. Picks it up. Got one. And two. They got both of them that time. Well, Adam Wainwright is heading off to the dugout. Quality pitching all around. A great duel. Seventh inning stretch in St. Louis.
Now up to the plate.
And Paul Goldschmidt to lead it off.
Number 46, Paul Goldschmidt.
Here's the pitch. Sinker drops in for a called strike.
You know, with an 0-1 count, we usually see him go with the heater. Sometimes he goes against green, but I think you have to go with the trainer.
The pitch. A fly ball. And it's going to be McCutchen. Able to glide over. Not much of a problem on that.
Well, these hitters are just lost up there right now. I mean, they have to think about changing their approach. 12 hitters in a row retired. At some point, you lay down a bunt or you try to go the other way. You got to try something.
And it's Molina at the plate. Grounded out last time. And he starts him out. First pitch, a big breaker for a called strike. Swing and a hot shot. Wow, that was close. Right back up the middle. Almost got him. That's two gone.
For the St. Louis Cardinals.
Well, it's now a Baker's dozen. First team in a row he set down. Absolutely lights out. What a performance.
Wong at the plate now. One for two in the ballgame. Here's the first pitch. That's enough for the breaking pitch inside, 1-0.
That curveball inside right there, pretty good pitch, but if he leaves it over the plate, he's going to get hurt.
The 1-0 now. Swung on, bounced weakly to second. Played by Hernandez. Throws to first in time, that's three down. Nothing doing here in this half inning. We're tied up here in St. Louis. Joining our 2K Sports Major League Baseball broadcast with John Kruk and Steve Phillips, I'm Gary Thorne. Franco settling in. He's going to lead off here as we go to the eighth. And it's fouled away. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Wainwright. 0-1 fastball and a called strike.
The location and velocity are critical in throwing the fastball. He runs his good fastball up and away right here, and it's a take pitch.
Big breaking ball misses, 1-2. One-two pitch coming. Fastball just about had him, and it's a 2-2 count. Here's the delivery. Ground ball towards second. Wong. And he throws out the first for the out. A little warm-up action going in the bullpen. That's a right-hander up and coming.
Well, they're going to wait for the right-handed hitter on deck to get announced, and then they'll probably make the move to the pen.
And it's Arrieta at the plate. He was a strikeout victim last time through the lineup. Here's the first pitch. And Wainwright misses outside, taken for a ball.
Well, he's over the 80 pitch mark right now at this point in the game. And you know that pitching coach is keeping a close eye on him to see if he tires.
Here's a swing and a line drive. And that is in there, the go-ahead run on base.
I thought he couldn't hit, Gary. Pitchers can't hit. Look at that. That's a good piece of hitting right there. Nice job.
Number 22, Andrew McCutchen.
Three ABs so far, picked up one hit off Wainwright.
Well, last time these two met, it ended with a hit off of that curveball. You wonder if he's going to go back to it early in the count.
Well, nobody scored on the double he had his last time up, but if he hits that again here, he could very well bring home the runner standing on first.
And here's the first one. Line towards third and foul. Hit well to the right side. Oh, and a great catch. Great reaction time to end up with that on the glove.
Well, it's a game of seconds, of split seconds, and his reactions allowed him to make that play.
Number two spot in the lineup up again. No hits yet, but he'll get another chance right here. Runner on first, two away. First pitch to him. Grounded softly to short. Number three. Throws to first, side is retired. No runs on a hit, and they'll scramble. We are deadlocked in St. Louis. And the number seven batter in the box. Drove in a run earlier in the game. Pat Neshek's going to be pitching. They've decided it was time to make a change here. The right center, and he's on. That's the go-ahead run.
Well, anytime you bring in a relief pitcher to come in a key situation, the last thing you want to do is for him to serve one up to the first hitter. That's exactly what he did, giving up that big base hit.
And the number eight spot rolls around. Flew out last time. And the first pitch, slider swung on and missed, 0-1.
Well, this one here, with no doubt about it, the late break on that slider, I mean, what a devastating pitch, and the hitter just couldn't catch up.
Hot shot towards the hole.
A perfect situational hitting. This is exactly the time you want to go the other way.
And what we're talking about is taking the ball where it's pitched. It's outside, go the other way. It's Wainwright at the plate. Getting close now to the top of the order, so you want this pitcher spot. Always you want it to be an out. Even if you get that here, you're still going to be a couple of outs to work with to create some offense. Here's the pitch. Pulls it back in time. It's 1-0. Pauses, and now the 1-0. And he lays one down here. Grabs it. Over to first for out number one.
Well, that's some fun right there. Moving up the base runners. Good execution.
That puts a couple in position to come across the plate. You talk about getting something done that matters. That's the case right there.
Now they're looking for the big hit. Gary, it's a high-pressure moment right here for Pat Neshek.
He's going to need to come up big right here. With runners on at second and third and only one away in a tie game, you need big outs.
Now, this is why you play the game, Gary. These situations, it's where the stars thrive.
Taps this one foul off to the left. Here's the delivery. Good patience. Dexter Fowler. He lets that one go by for a ball. Count is even.
What a great spot to put that pitch if you can get the guy to chase.
Changeup misses, and it's 2-1. Dexter Fowler now has the count in his favor as it goes to 3-1.
Well, this is your dream when you're in the on-deck circle before you go into the batter's box. If you can get the count to 3-1 and in your favor, you know you have the upper hand.
The 3-2 pitch. That's a call, strike three. Dexter Fowler got him.
Well, that's a huge out right there. Now with two down, they've got a legitimate chance of getting out of this inning with the game still tied.
It's going to be Carpenter now. Trying again here, just 1-for-3 thus far. Cardinals at second and third with two out. Too far outside, 1-0. Neshek with a windup. This is outside for ball two.
No, he doesn't want to fall behind 3-0. He commands his fastball better than any other pitch, so look for him to throw it.
Finger just misses the paint. Runs up to 3-0.
And when he can keep that thing down and away, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Ball four. Now you got the sacks full.
Tries to get the ground ball with the sinker ball, but he drops it out of the zone. And now, you know what? Base is loaded here. What a jam.
And in the batter's box, it's Ozuna. And he needs to come through here with two down.
Infield got to play back in this situation and get the out at the easiest base.
Here's the first pitch. That one's going to be outside. Ball one.
When you throw a breaking ball like this, you want to start it on the corner and break it off the zone, trying to get the hitter to chase. The hitter didn't take the bait here.
And he looks at a slider that's in there. 1-1.
Down, down, down. It's all about location. That breaking ball down in the zone makes it very difficult on the hitter.
Swung, ground ball to short. He grabs it. Throws on to first in time to retire the side. So they pick up two hits in the inning but leave the bases loaded. We're tied up here in St. Louis.
Bryce Harper looks ready in that batter's box. He wants to deliver in the clutch.
Well, we're in the top half of the last inning. This ball game tied up, so the potential go-ahead is up there.
Now, this is what you're playing for. You can throw all the scouting reports, everything out the door. It's one against one. Who can win it?
Now the 1-0 pitch. Now bouncing ball to short. Oh, throw a star on that one. Goldschmidt corrals it. And safe at first. And he throws it away. Cleanup man in the box again. Well, he digs in here, Steve. A golden opportunity to be the hero.
And with nobody out, they need to find a way to advance the runner into scoring position.
Oh, he's trying to steal second. And he is out trying to take second. He gets caught on that one. Boy, they didn't wait very long to go.
Well, he went on the first pitch, and he didn't catch anybody by surprise as they looked ready for it. Good pitch to throw, and the catcher gets him out.
And they thought they had that pitcher read, and he was wrong. The pitch from Wainwright. Sinker, one ball, one strike. Three at bats and three hits. Gotta like that one. No problem driving the ball off Wainwright.
But he didn't seem to have any problem handling the sinker the last time around. Was able to go down and get it. Got to believe he's looking for it again.
Here's a strike, bottom half of the zone, 1-2 now.
And you can throw the ball down in the zone with that kind of movement. It can be very effective.
This one is lined softly towards second. They take care of that one.
Well, he might have had himself a hit if he could just have gotten it up over the second baseman. Unfortunately, not high enough. He's able to make the play.
Up again now, the number five spot. Had an RBI single his last time to the plate. Here's the first pitch. Fastball misses away. 1-0. It's 1-1.
One thing we know is he's not going to take a borderline pitch at 1-1. He likes to swing the bat, so I'm not giving him anything too fine and see if I can't get him to hit into an easy out.
1-1 pitch. Carpenter. He'll throw on to first, and that'll do it for this half inning. Three up, three down this half inning. Still a tie game in St. Louis.
Back.
and a real opportunity for Paul Goldschmidt to come up big for his team.
Long crowd is hoping, and this may be their final hope, maybe their best hope, a chance to win it here in the bottom half of the last inning.
Now the crowd electric right now, excited, on their feet. They know two of the game's best going head-to-head.
Here's the pitch. And he leaves that one alone. Paul Goldschmidt, with good patience there, and the count is now even. One pitch, a sinker, taken for a strike, 1-2. The 1-2 pitch. I don't know how you lay off that sinker, but it's 2-2. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Slider just about had him, 3-2 count.
If you're going to miss, this is where you want to miss. Throw that breaking ball at the bottom of the strike zone. If the hitter swings and puts it in play, it's a ground ball out.
Lost it. Ball four. That puts the potential winning run on.
Well, after a long, epic battle, this at-bat ends in a walk? Are you kidding me? Someone should have got struck out or someone should have got a hit, but the hitter will take the walk.
Now it's Yadier Molina. He needs to move over that go-ahead run that's at first.
He's got to do anything he can to advance this runner and get him into scoring position.
They've got the outs to work with. And starts him out here. First pitch, a sinker away, 1-0.
That's a good spot to miss with that thing, just off the corner.
Here's the pitch. Yadier Molina swings and misses. Count is even.
Well, this one here was no doubt about it. The late break on that slider. I mean, what a devastating pitch, and the hitter just couldn't catch up.
Now the 1-1. Foul! And it goes foul. 1-2 pitch coming. Lined hard down the left field line. And this is a fair ball heading towards the corner.
Takes his 1-2 pitch down in the zone. He's able to go down and get it. Get a good part of the bat on the ball and pick up the base hit.
That's a tough pitch to hit when you're behind in the count. You just want contact, and he got it.
Gary, it's a high-pressure moment right here for Pat Hischa.
This is quite a jam. He finds himself in here. Two on, nobody else.
Well, he's got to stop the bleeding right here, Gary. Get the pitches down in the zone and keep it in the infield.
Molina on second, Goldschmidt at third. First pitch is a changeup for a called strike.
Well, now that he's in the hole and behind, I suspect we're going to see a heater coming in there.
He deals. On the ground to short. Oh, he's going to try to make the play. In time for the out.
Well, it's a big first out right there, but he finds himself still in a jam, in a tie game. It's going to be absolutely critical to be aggressive with the next hitter.
There's shortstop in the box. He's looking to put an end to it right now.
A base hit or a short fly ball probably puts an end to this.
That'll be a game winner. And here's the first one. Starts him out with a slider for a strike.
Well, he has great rotation on his breaking ball right here, and he hits the perfect spot. The hitter just gave up on him.
He delivers. Check swing. He held up in time. 1-1. A swing line to left center. And there it is. Could this be it? And they win it. Game-winning run is across.
Walk-off win for the whole team, getting it done in extraordinary fashion. Everybody celebrating.
And it's that time in our broadcast where we bestow upon some lucky winner, the player of the game. A commanding performance by the starter, Adam Wainwright.
Well, you know, Gary, he made just that one mistake, but that doesn't tarnish the shine of this performance today. And I'll tell you what, the manager absolutely loves it when he doesn't have to go to the bullpen. He can give those guys a day off, and it makes them stronger for the remainder of the season. But I tell you, this guy was throwing strikes today, and it was an easy decision to keep him in the game.
And, Steve, that ought to send these folks home happy.
Oh, no question about it. They get the win in a close game, a lot of excitement and enthusiasm, and ready for the next one.
And we hope you've enjoyed today's 2K Sports broadcast of Major League Baseball. For Steve, John, and our entire 2K Sports crew, I'm Gary Thorne. We will see you soon.